Hi everybody, I hope you're all doing well today. Now, a lot of people are paying attention to the cameras on the iPhone 12 Pro Max because they have the bigger sensor, but a lot of people are gonna get the mini, I feel like. So let's see what this camera can get up to. Now, originally I was supposed to shoot a short film on it, however, some actors became unavailable, so that unfortunately will not be happening. This is a pretty long video, so there are chapter times down below that will let you skip around to different parts of the video that interest you the most. But let's go ahead and get started with our green screen test. This was a tech test for the short film I was going to be doing. This is the iPhone 12 mini, 4K, 24 frames a second. What really took my breath away was how far we were able to scale the footage in and still get really sharp videos. But at 322%, that image still being really sharp was really impressive from a camera like this. Likewise, I was also really impressed with the color grading I was able to do and the color correction. So being able to really draw out the green to get a better key in, and also the color correction for the skin tones. Skin tones and the iPhone video camera have always been a bit of an issue, but they do look much better with the iPhone 12. Although I'm not wearing foundation makeup, so if I was wearing makeup, I would be less shiny, but it's still really impressive for a test like this. You're now going to see me piece this all together for the proof of concept, and I was really impressed with what I delivered really fast, because if this was done properly and put more time into it, you would get much better results. Hi, it's me. Am I serving you? What time is it over there? Look, it's nothing, it's just... I keep thinking about Big. Why did I do a line reading from Sex and the City? And why did I butcher it? I was really impressed by what I did there with the green screening. Now look, it isn't perfect. I did that quite fast. And for example, if I'd done it in After Effects, I feel like I probably would have fixed the hair issue that you kind of saw a little bit of. But I actually think the biggest giveaway was the sound, because my room is quite echoey and it doesn't sound like outside. You know, if I had set up that green screen outside and I got a more natural outdoor sound, it probably would have been pretty convincing. The green screening was done at 250% scale, okay? This is 100%, so I zoomed in 2.5 times and the quality was still sharp enough for a grade. That's unheard of when it comes to green screening. When you do green screening, you film your actor at the height and frame that you want them at. You don't really punch in and green screen that way, because you want as much detail as possible. So the fact that the iPhone 12 mini could capture that much detail just in the camera app and deliver that was fantastic. I think the Dolby Vision HDR makes a big difference, because I was really able to saturate that green to separate it from the reds and the blues to get a really good key. So while I was really nervous about keying in HDR, it actually turned out to be a bit of a blessing, because I had access to so much more color gamut. This section of the video still serves as a studio test, because I have some lights on now. I have a light on me and I have a light for the background. This bit's actually filmed in Filmic Pro. They have just released an update for iPhone 12 mini, so we're recording in Filmic Pro. Quality should be kind of better because I have it set to Filmic Extreme. Although with Dolby Vision HDR turned on, it disables a lot of features you find in Filmic Pro. So I'd actually say that if you get an iPhone 12 mini and you want to shoot in Dolby Vision HDR, I wouldn't necessarily get Filmic Pro. I actually started my YouTube channel on my iPhone XS Max, and actually a really old DSLR. That got me to, you know, basically like 85,000 views before I bought a used Sony A7S II. And you know, the quality for that was good enough to get my channel started, but the quality on this is just so much better. I didn't think the quality was going to be that much better with studio lights. I thought they'd be just marginally better, but there's a huge improvement. I mean, you can go back and look at my older videos. I was really unhappy with skin tones on the iPhone XS Max, and it's much improved on the 12. I actually don't think skin tones were great on the 11 either, because the issues I were having with the skin tone was actually the same issues that Lady Gaga had in her music video for the iPhone 11. That kind of pasty look, that actually seems to have gone away with the iPhone 12, which I'm super excited about. I'm so excited about skin tones on an iPhone. Finally, look, they're not as amazing as like an A7S III or something, but it's definitely an improvement over previous iPhones. This is a 60 frames test. I went to my go-to of filming the dogs being crazy. They're running around the house. You know, I never noticed this, but when the iPhone doesn't have a lot of light, the image really desaturates, so I tried to bring some of the color back in with a grade. But as you can see, the 60 frames performance is just brilliant. I mean, it does exactly what it says on the tin when I slow it down to 50%. It's very fluid, very smooth, very nice frame rate presentation. For the short film I was gonna do, this is another tech test of our attic because we're gonna turn it into like a studio apartment with a bit of, you know, production design. And I was doing an exposure test to see which would give me the best presentation because I never really liked how much noise the iPhone produces. And I felt if I was testing different exposures, maybe one would produce less noise. I was absolutely right. The iPhone performs its best when it's underexposed. So this is at -2 and it looks the best. And even though it's quite dark, you can still do a lot with it, but because of those HDR colors. So this was a color test with the HDR. I think it looks really good, still -2. I was really impressed that even with such a dark exposure, you could do a lot with coloring and you know, kind of give it a nice mood. If you decide to overexpose, this is +1. You're just gonna get something that's really blown out. Blown out video is never fun, and just also a lot of noise in the image, and it's not a great presentation. Likewise, at +2, it's becoming basically unusable. The highlights are even being blown out beyond its dynamic range. Not great. This is another test for our hallway. Here, you're probably trying to underexpose to bring in the highlights from outside in the sky. I still think -2 has the best presentation, even though it's so bizarrely dark. It's just less blurry. As you see, at the higher the exposure, just the more noise the camera has. Now I have turned the lights on, and as you can see, give the phone as much light as you can and the quality improves. Now, -2, it's still really dark even with the lights on, but at -1, this was my favorite out of all of them. It's a good compromise between great presentation and actually having usable footage. However, once you're shooting outside during the day, you probably won't have to deal with this mess. As you can see, at normal exposure, it looks fantastic. This is it at -1, where it also looks pretty good. It is very dark at -2, but there's no reason for you to shoot at -2 as the normal exposure has an amazing presentation. And here I really boosted those colors and it looks fantastic. I took these pictures at 2 a.m. in pitch black and I was pretty impressed with night mode. Pretty good quality, but most importantly, it gives you live preview on the viewfinder, so it's very usable. As expected though, especially with the S20 FE, the ultra wide angle lens is terrible, particularly in low light conditions. This is why I don't have any beautiful photography with the iPhone 12, because Ireland is just dark and wet right now, it's winter. But I took a frame from this video because I thought it'd be a great case study to show how HDR works for better and worse. And as you can see here, the sky has a lot of blue peeking out because, again, the HDR is so extreme that I can even see that there's some blue in the sky. The issue though here is when you try to grade it, you know, try to make it look a bit better, you're going to run into some issues if you try to grade it like SDR. So as you see here, this is a color board. A lot of people use these to try to lower the blacks, as they say. And as you can see, you get some really awful artifacts. You really have to treat this footage more like S-Log or V-Log or RE RAW, or basically, you know, ungraded, because you're going to have to go into your color curves. As you see here, this is with the color curves. You have a much nicer presentation. I cut off all the blue and I boosted the greens and the reds just to put something in its favor so the image wasn't desaturated. Testing dynamic range will be hard because the weather is crap, but the iPhone 12 is really good at pulling in color. Adding color boosts to your video is definitely not an issue. As for dynamic range, even with the really bad weather, you can kind of see that it's still relatively bright outside, and yet these statues and ornaments still stay in focus. However, if one area in your image is dark, there's really no point to it. The image is still going to be pretty noisy, unusable. It's much better in this scenario when both areas of the image are relatively bright, just one of them is brighter than the other, and that's where the dynamic range kicks in and the image looks good. Otherwise, the video is sharp as long as it's well lit. I mean, that's a consistent theme. These phones need lots of light in them. Outside, I think it's really vivid, a really great color. With the Dolby Vision HDR, you can really punch in as we just did there and get some really beautiful colors from the image. And again, very sharp, no noise when there is plenty of light. That said, what impressed me the most was even in darkness, the amount of color I was able to pull out of the image was really impressive. Look at the blue. This is the 4K front-facing test, again with Dolby Vision. As long as you have a lot of light, it looks pretty good. It's about to get dark because this is Ireland in the winter. But it actually still looks pretty clear right now, pretty sharp, and the blacks look good. The front-facing camera does take decent quality selfies, you know, very good quality, pretty sharp. The video, as you saw earlier, was pretty grainy. I would have expected better if I'm being honest, especially since being outside. I think everybody knows how I feel about these ultra wide lenses. I really don't like them. They're not great for really anything. They don't take in a lot of light and they're not particularly sharp. So while maybe some people might find it useful, I probably would have just preferred them to put a telephoto lens instead and not have an ultra wide at all if they could only have two. I mean, here at night mode, it's basically unusable. It's a bit better there, but overall, you know, you're gonna be using the main camera 99% of the time. Portrait mode is as good as ever. I think it takes really nice pictures, whether you're using the rear camera or the front facing. It looks very, very beautiful. And also even using the natural and studio mode, it does great selfies, and your dogs also always will look amazing in portrait mode. If you enjoyed the video, do leave a comment below and let me know, or at least you know if you found the video informative, because that was a long video and I don't know if enjoyment is necessarily what you'd get from that information dump. But if you plan on getting an iPhone 12, do let me know, and if you have any questions about the camera system that I did not answer for you. And let me know if you plan on shooting anything on the iPhone 12. Are you a photographer, videographer, filmmaker? Do let me know. If you liked the video, do subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell to stay tuned for future uploads. But I hope you guys are all staying safe and well, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye.